my cousin in the civil service, but he wouldn't be very likely to want to communicate with me. We haven't spoken for years.
Are you Mr. Condiman's cousin in the civil service? I'm afraid you probably. Can you think of anyone else? Rack your brains. It's my field, Mrs. Plummet. She died on Whit Monday, too.
I can't imagine why every Mrs. Plummet should wish to speak with me. You have very little in common.
It's worth trying, Cap. Are you ill, Mrs. Plummet? She was rather dead. Perhaps you'd better shout. Are you old, Mrs. Plummet? I'm afraid there's no one there at all.
Oh, how disappointing. It was coming along so nicely.
Violet, be quiet.
Oh. I'm afraid I shall have to go into a trance. I had wished to avoid it because it was so exhausting. Excuse me for a moment while I start the record.
Oh, please, don't make always.
Why am I not, Charles? Do be observed. I'm afraid it would be imprudent to change horses in midstream,
you know. Hop your own way, then.
Keep still, Charles. He goes touching for a moment.
Like some more.
to leave your bicycle here and let us drive.
I honestly do think you should have your cot. You can't be feeling quite yourself after the trance and everything.
Nonsense, my dear. I feel as fit as a fiddle after my little trance. It always reduces. Well, good night, Mrs. Condamine.
It was awfully sweet of you to take so much trouble.
I'm sorry so little occurred. It's that cold of that as I expected.
You know what children are like. Is anything wrong with them?
We must really try again some evening.
That would be lovely.
Good night, Mrs. Brad. It was a thrilling evening. I absolutely felt the table shaking underneath my arms. Good night, Dr. Brad.
Congratulations, Madam Arbuckle.
I'm fully aware of the irony in your tone, Dr. Brad, and I should like to say you would make an admirable subject for telepathic hypnosis. A great chum of mine is an expert, and I should like to have him look you over.
I'm sure I shall be charmed.
Well,